Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. What is biasing? Biasing voltage. This is a question from my viewer. He watched my video on power supply and he asked, what is biasing voltage? To understand the word biasing, I will give a simple example. I have a car in my home. Its fuel is finished, so it needs fuel to power up so that we can drive it. To provide fuel, first I will go to any petrol pump, any fuel station. I will bring some, we can say 2 liter, 3 liter, 5 liter petrol, and I will fill the fuel in this car so that I can start it. When it will start, it will reach to fuel station. We will refill it and we can drive it. We can say the basic requirement to drive this car, that is fuel. This fuel, it was for startup only, to run for a limited time. So it will be called startup. It will work for this portion. When we will refill fuel from here, then we can drive up to our required distance. When I have this power supply board, it have AC line, then it is rectified to DC. We will receive positive and negative supply here. Then these positive voltage are provided to transformer, any switching device, MOSFET, and then here. To drive this transistor, MOSFET, IGBT, we have a section here that is called PWM controller. It is separate circuit. So to operate this IC, this section, we need this fuel. So first, because it was powered off, when we will apply power, the power will reach here to this circuit, but to start working this IC, we need some amount of fuel so that it will start working. For that purpose, here it have, because we are dealing with voltage here, a resistor that is called startup resistor. Then this voltage will reach here. We connect a capacitor here and this voltage will reach here. Because this IC works at very low amount of voltage, we can say its power supply is 9 volt, 10 volt, maximum up to 20 volt, 30 volt. For that purpose, this resistor can provide a very limited amount of current so that it can provide just only little amount of fuel to start up. When it will start to charge this capacitor, when this capacitor will charge, it can provide initial start, that is called startup. For example, initially this capacitor was at 0 volt and this IC have interlock. Until this capacitor will reach up to 16 volt, then this IC will start. When it will start switching, it will start switching this transformer. At that time, we need a secondary winding to produce voltage. So we will take output from secondary side. Limitation here that this resistor cannot provide enough current to run this IC all the time, because it have very limited current. For that purpose, we have an additional winding here. This end is grounded. And we have a rectifier here that will provide voltage, and this voltage will reach here. So this winding is called VCC winding, bias winding, auxiliary winding. This additional winding in the primary side, it provides the running voltage for this IC. The same example here, we bring some fuel for startup until we can drive to this station. When it will reach here, we will provide enough amount of fuel so that it will run safely here. This resistor provides limited current and this capacitor charges up to a specific level. When this IC will start, it will start consuming these voltage. From here, it cannot replenish the voltage level for that purpose. For smooth running of this IC, it needs more current. When it will start switching, current will flow from this negative side to this positive side. In the result of switching, this winding create magnetic field. This magnetic field caused to induce voltage here. The same magnetic field will applied here. It will produce voltage here. These voltage are rectified and these are looped back to VCC pin so that this IC will receive its enough amount of current so that it will work normally. So this is called biasing or bias voltage. In simple words, we can say biasing voltage are amount of DC voltage to which are provided to any circuit to start working. For example, I have this multimeter. If I will connect to any point to measure voltage, to measure resistance, it will not do anything. First, I need to connect batteries inside, so it will power up. When it will power up, then we can take any useful function from this device. We have a cassette player here. We apply voltage to a transformer. It provides voltage. We rectify it and we provide to the cassette player, to the circuit and cassette player mechanism. When we will inject cassette, its motor will spin, its tape will run to the magnetic head. That head will read the information of that tape. That signal is provided here. When this signal is reached here, this circuit will start processing and we will receive output in the speaker. If we don't have power supply and we inject cassette, it will not play. This circuit cannot provide audio signal for this speaker. When this circuit will power up, then it will perform its dedicated function. The same way we said, here we have a resistor here, startup resistor. If you check, this is positive line. Positive voltage are reaching here at this point. Then we have a resistor here. And then second resistor here, two resistors in series. From this positive line to here at this capacitor. Positive voltage from here to this node, and then we have this line and we are receiving voltage at this capacitor. This one. One resistor here, second resistor here. When this IC will receive power at its this pin, VCC pin, it will start switching, and it will start switching for few milliseconds. Why? Because these resistors are high value resistors and these cannot provide enough amount of current so that this IC cannot run for long time. It will run for a very short span of time, that is called startup time. When it will start switching, it will drive this power MOSFET, it will drive this transformer. This will drive this primary winding that we discussed here. Then we have an additional winding, that is VCC winding, bias winding or auxiliary winding, that is this one. One end of this winding is grounded. We can see that is negative pole of this capacitor. And here at this point we have one component here. This one, that is diode. That we discussed here. When this MOSFET will switch, it will pass these voltage to this winding. Positive voltage are provided here. It will switch. When it will switch, we will receive voltage in this winding and we will receive voltage in this winding. So these auxiliary voltage, bias voltage, VCC voltage are provided from this winding, and this type of voltage which we need for smooth running of this IC, that are bias voltage. I hope this video is informative. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.